I could go off the deep end. I could kill all my best friends. I could follow those stylish trends. And God knows I could make amends. But I've got an angry heart, filled with cancers and poppy tarts. If this is how you folks make art, it's fucking depressing. And it's sad to know that we are not alone. And it's sad to know there's no honest way out. I'm afraid to leave the house.
The sweat just to cash checks, working from sunrise to set. Every day get challenged, no trades or talents. Barely scraped by, he found faith. The balance, a straight line and pace, feeling worn and gray. Poor with four seeds, one more on the way. It was hard days indeed, all work and no play. He made sure things on the surface were okay, but something disturbing within his mind was lurking. A slight twilight breeze would ease in through the curtains at night. It's like the sermon of a twisted apparition was urging him to listen to the drain in the distance. At first it wasn't intense, just one little instance. Sure, it didn't occur, he turned to resist it, as if it wasn't much more than just a figment of his imagination. But for days it was persistent, and it went, noticed he was acting berserk. Granny got a call saying he was absent from work, and that was the first she ran to the pastor at church to ask him what was up with this disastrous curse. But bad with the worst, he came back 3 days after, no money in his wallet and his shirt on backwards. Stumbling, walked awkward, he called out for his daughter right before he split. The last lesson he taught her was this: if you ever have a son, let him know that his granddad loved him. But by the time that he's grown, be sure the seed is sown deep down into his dome. Don't ever, ever walk to the train tracks alone. With that, he backed up, reached out for his jacket, told her not to act up and cracked up laughing. After all that happened, he left never to be seen. 15 years later, it's when my mother had me. Her dad lived a life people can't understand. Went from a family man to rambling man, a gambling man that burned both ends of the candle. Folded his hand in, it was too hot to handle.
Sitting by the tracks, waiting for the night train, looking down the road, ain't never gonna go back. Listen for the whistle through the wind and rain now. Who's gonna ride the devil's train tonight? Sitting by the tracks, waiting for the night train, looking down the road.
When I was a child, my mom dropped fables and stories to warn me of the dangers that were laying before me. To keep it interesting, she would hide the lesson, to guide my direction, provide the right message. In time, I developed a sense of her embellishments. Hence, I was rebellious against what she was telling me. When I was a teen, I pretended that my demons were friends. I defended the place, yo, and that was the case. Slurred speech tripping off of my face. The world creeped as I slipped to the awfulest place you could imagine. Not the average things you see on acid. My granddad bloody hovering on a speaker cabinet, laughing in a raspy tone, covered in maggots. A snack on his mass of the bone, I couldn't grasp it. Did a double dismount off of the couch, flipped out, broke the closest window I found, then I dipped out. Suddenly, I discovered little voices mumbling up in my head. It had me wondering, what was it my mother said back when I was younger? It had my brain racked as I stumbled off of the night towards the train tracks.
Sitting by the tracks, waiting for the night train, looking down the road, ain't never gonna go back. Listen for the whistle through the wind and rain now. Who's gonna ride the devil's train tonight? Sitting by the tracks, waiting for the night train, looking down the road, ain't never gonna go back. Listen for the whistle through the wind and rain now. Who's gonna ride the devil's train tonight?
So there I was, walking through the dark with a buzz. I figured I should walk, that'll ease me off of these drugs. It's like a shark had to keep moving, it's that'd be ruined. If I sat still, I was doomed, and that wasn't doing. So I marched
march through the park, slow gone like Donnie Darko. The sparkle of the starlight glowed like charcoal. Despite my demeanor, the night seemed more serene than a morphine fiend in the morgue. It seemed like I'd lost it. That was when my grandpop's carcass emerged from the dark, gurgling his words of carnage, but he couldn't talk. Something about the birth of sadness. I scurried off, I was on the verge of madness. I raced fast pace and the landscape was strange, like a plane parallel to this one, but rearranged. Came to a slope that was steep, begging for sleep as I climbed up, taking my focus off of the creeps. But in the foggy distance, I saw a silhouette that got bigger as I stepped. The train tracks were wet. I saw a shiny grin from afar like it was happy. This is what he said as he started to walk past.
It's a nice night for a walk. Would you mind if I joined you?
Do what you want
to
do.
Well, that's great, because I'm going to. And not to annoy you, but see, I really have to ask what a young dude like you is doing out by the tracks. You waiting on a train?
Nah, man, let me explain.